we stopped at certificate of delivery, certificate of manufacture, and delivery, which is this particular form. 7512, form 7512, certificate of delivery, certificate of manufacture and delivery. And so we use one form for both. As we know that from the previous lectures, we know that the Trade Facilitation and Trade Enforcement Act made those forms non-mandatory, and right now customs have not implemented regulation as of yet. They may anytime soon. In fact, they may by the time you watch this lecture, if you are looking at the playback. So be mindful, this may go away as a mandatory, but because this has been a requirement, customs examiners have a very important procedural requirement because it establishes the chain of custody. And the chain of custody, who owns the title of the product, where it went, what happened to it, is very important for drawback purposes, because it gives you an idea, it gives customs an idea of what happened to the product while it was in the country. All right, so certificate of delivery is required when any party is making a transfer. So one of the questions, the focus is on the transfer, of course. When we analyze the questions, we have to ask ourselves, has the transfer been made? So here, let's look at one of the customs exam questions from the past. AB importer, before we go in there, we have to go back and remind ourselves who has a right to claim drawback. And the parties who have a claim to claim drawback by default are the exporter and destroyer for unused merchandise and manufacturing drawback. And for rejected merchandise drawback, it is usually the importer, right? And all the other parties must have some kind of transfer and the assignment of rights in order to make a claim for that drawback. All right, now, let's take a look. AB importer imports engines from Germany through Chicago. So one thing we have to look for is who is the importer, who is the exporter, and was there a transfer, and if there was there an assignment? So here we have first thing we establish is the importer, exporter, and assignment, chain of custody. All right, so importer is AB importer. Then they sell them to the CD company, which repackages and exports them to Germany through freight forwarder. So the exporter is CD company. Drawback can rightfully be claimed by, and you have to fill in the blank. All right, number one, A, CD company with a certificate of delivery issued by AB importer. So certificate of delivery is a document which establishes the chain of custody, which establishes the transfer. A certificate of delivery, let's go back to that form. Certificate of delivery, certificate of manufacturer's delivery, does make the transfer rights, right? And does make the assignments right declaration. So this is very important points. And here, CD company. So the call of the question is, who can claim the drawback. We know that exporter CD company can claim the drawback, right? But it has to have, because there was a transfer that took place from AB importer to CD company, there must be certificate of delivery. So CD company with certificate of delivery issued by AB importer, right? Because it was the original party who had the product in its possession and custody and ownership. It had a title to it. It is the entity that should issue the certificate of delivery. So A is the correct answer choice. As long as that certificate of delivery is in place, right? AB importer without any additional documentation. Well, no, you have to have some documentation. You have to have certificate of delivery. Nowadays, you have to have documents in after Trade Enforcement and Trade Facilitation Act, the documents that are regularly kept in the ordinary course of business. So no additional documentation is false. CD company with a certificate of delivery issued by freight forwarder. Okay, freight forwarder is just a party that's moving freight. It has no title to the product. It has no title to the goods. So freight forwarder is obviously not the party to issue the document. D, freight forwarder without any additional documentation. Again, freight forwarder is not the party with the title. It's the party who just moving freight. E, AB importer with certificate of delivery issued by CD company. Now this one is a possibility, right? So AB importer has a certificate of delivery. So notice that AB issued a certificate of delivery to CD company, right? And then CD company issues, so it does what it does, and it issues certificate, it gives assignment to claim drawback rights to AB company. AB company then goes to CBP, and then, because CD company, as an exporter, assigns its right to claim drawback back to AB, this is something that happened. Now, what happens? How do you assign the right, right? You have to look at the document itself. You have to look at the certificate of delivery itself. And you know that the assignment of rights is actually made on certificate of delivery itself. So certificate of delivery is a document that causes the assignment of rights. Moreover, if we go to the Code of Federal Regulations, So we're on drawback, so we're talking about the part 191. Okay. Let's go to part 191. All right, so 191.10 is the part that is devoted to the certificate of delivery. And the one of the purposes for the certificate of delivery is assignment of rights. So is assignment of rights, can it be done through certificate of delivery? Yes. And they further recommend us to take a look at part 190.182. And if we take a look at part 190.182, persons entitled to claim drawback, we will see that unless otherwise provided, the exporter, right, the exporter here is CD company, right, unless the exporter, right, by means of certification through the 7552, right, it makes, waives the right, and makes affirmation that it does not assign the right to claim drawback to anyone else but to AB. In other words, if they assign this under 191.82, AB can claim drawback, but you have to have that type of function taking place. So, going back to our our particular question that we talk about. AB importer with a certificate of delivery issued by the CD company, if they use that another certificate of delivery to document the chain of custody and assignment of right to claim drawback back to AB, right? Then they can go to CBP and claim that. So technically speaking, provided that this type of mechanism take place, then it is a possibility. So because this is a possibility, and because this is a possibility, why is this a correct answer choice? As you know, customs examiners on the notice of examination on and on the instructions, they always they usually say that each question is designed to have a single best answer. And we know that the through our analysis, we know that the definition of best answer usually means that you it is something which is more simple. This is something which is more straight to the point type of answer, which we are dealing which we are dealing at this particular moment and particular time. If we have to guess, if we have to engage in some kind of second degree analysis and we have to draw a more complicated picture, then it is not the best answer. So given that background, because this one provides a straight to the point, you have CD company that got certificate of delivery from the importer. So chain of custody, the CD company is the default exporter, right? So it's a default party that can claim right can claim drawback, meaning that it is straight to the point. No second step, which would be CD assignment of rights to AB and AB going to customs. So in A, CD company goes straight to customs. In E, it goes to AB, back to AB, and AB goes to customs. So that's more difficult level, and because it's more difficult, more complicated steps, that means that this is not the best answer. So this is I think a good example to also get a sneak preview of what best answer rule means. So here customs picked A as the best answer and the correct answer. All right, next one. Which situation does not require CBP form 7552 certificate of delivery to claim drawback? All right, so we're looking for the transfer, right? If there was a transfer, if there was no transfer, then no form 7552 is required. So A U.S. importer sells 40 cases of imported ink pen cartridges to another company to be repackaged and exported to Turkey. Was there a transfer? Yes. Sells to another company. So there was a transfer. So 7512 is required. A company in Newark imports French soap and sells it to a company in Miami. So Newark, Miami transfer. So transfer does take place in B. C. A Florida company imports ball bearings from Singapore, intermingles them with other imported and domestic ball bearings, and sells them to Seattle company. So Florida company sells them to Seattle company, and there is a manufacturing drawback. So yes, there is a transfer. In here, transfer of you have unused merchandise here. You have manufacturing merchandise drawback, but still there is a transfer. And 7552 can be used for the manufacturing drawback claim as well as the unused merchandise drawback claim. D. Minneapolis company buys a shipment of Taiwanese seaweed from importer of record in LA and exports it to Finland. So here you have Los Angeles to Minneapolis company transfer. Here they put transferor first to the transferee. Here they put transferee first to the transferor. But still, there is transfer taking place. So 7552 is required. E.